This is our 2006 Toyota Corolla, and today I want to show you how to replace the front brake pads. This is the front right rotor, and the disc seems to be fine. There's no grooves or many cracks that I can see. So what you will need for this is undo this bolt, and you do that via a 14mm socket, and that'll allow the brake caliper to open up. Then we can remove the brake pads and have a better look at them. And this bolt can be a bit tough sometimes. Okay. I'll just move it. Now I only need to do this bolt, I don't need to do the other one. And then this will allow us to open up the caliper, leave it there, and have a better look at the brake pads. It's probably a good idea to wear some gloves and just a bit of gentle prod. We'll get them out. That's number one. That's the outside. And that's the inside. Now there is a difference between outside and inside, so just make sure you're aware of that. So we'll just quickly measure the lining. So that's about 3mm, 2 to 3mm. The inside and the outside is about 5mm. So the inside has worn a lot quicker than the outside pad. And the brake pads for this model Corolla are the DB1431CAs. Now what was causing the screeching noise was actually these steel bits here, which have been pressed out now. But what they are, they're brake pad wear indicators. So when they get thin, like this is, they start making a screeching noise. So that's how you know when your brake pads need replacement. So this is a brand new one, and you can just see the difference between the linings and their thicknesses. So 2 to 3 mil for the old one, and these measure about 11 mil. And there's just a side-by-side comparison of the old and the new. So before we fit the new brake pads, we want to check the thickness of the rotor. The minimum thickness is 23mm. If it's below that, there's no point putting new brake pads on, because we'll also need to replace the rotors. So let's check that using a micrometer. Okay, so looking about 24.65. So we're going to use this brake and parts cleaner spray. Just going to spray it around the disc and the caliper. Careful you don't get any of the paintwork because it might strip it. And just watch out for the brake line as well. And just give it a good clean before we put the new pads on. So now that's dried, we're ready to put on the new pads. Now I said before that there might be an inside and outside pad. Some cars it is. Doesn't look like on this car it is. So here goes the inside pad. So just in the engine bay, this is our brake fluid container. Just want to open up the lid like that, just so air can flow and doesn't build up pressure and allow us to push this piston back a lot easier. So to push the piston back, you can either use a block of wood or the old brake pad. Just put it where the piston itself is, get a decent G-clamp, and just fit it to size, like that. Just make sure you don't start pressing on the brake line. And then we're going to slowly push that in. Back it off, take the clamp away, take the old pad. So the piston itself has moved in quite a bit, and that should give it all up to, there we go, easy. Just a matter of bolting it on, like that. Don't over tighten, you don't want to snap this bolt. And that's done. Just do final checks, that'll tighten up once the wheel goes back on, so that's fine. Now we'll fit the tyre back on and do up the bolts. And then we'll repeat the same process on the other side. Spinning alright, no rubs. So we'll do the same on the other side, and don't forget to put your cap back on the brake fluid container. And then the next step is to actually bed in the front rotors, and we do that by driving the car up to about 10 kilometers, slowing down 20, slowing down 30, repeating that process and doing it again with a bit more pressure and a bit more pressure after that. And that way they bed into the existing rotors. So that's how you change the front pads. Next step is to take it for a test drive and bed in those rotors. Thanks for watching.